he was in every direction I looked at. I stopped in my place without any movement until Khadija sent someone to look for me. He went down to Mecca and came back while I was standing in the same place. Gabriel then left. I went back home. I found Khadija at home, so I sat very close to her. She asked Father of Al-Qasim, "Where have you been?" I sent someone to look for you. He went to Mecca and returned to me. I told her of what I had seen. She replied, "It is a propitious sign. Oh, my husband, pull yourself together. I swear by Allah that you are a messenger for this nation." Then she stood up and went to Waraka and informed him. Waraka said, "I swear by Allah that he has received the same Namus, angel that was sent to Moses. He is the prophet of this nation. Tell him to be patient." She came back to him and told him of Waraka's words. When the messenger of Allah finished his solitary stay and went down to Mecca, he went to Waraka, who told him, "You are the prophet of this nation. I swear by Allah that you have received the same angel that was sent to Moses." Interruption of revelation. Reported on the authority of Ibn that the revelation paused for a few days after careful study, this seems to be the most possible to say that it lasted for 3.5 years, as some scholars allege is not correct, but here there is no room to go into more details. Meanwhile, the prophet was caught in a sort of depression coupled with astonishment and perplexity. Al-Bukhari reported, the divine inspiration paused for a while and the prophet became so sad, as we have heard, that he intended several times to throw himself from the tops of high mountains, and every time he went up the top of a mountain in order to throw himself down, Gabriel would appear before him and say, "O Muhammad, you are indeed Allah's messenger in truth," whereupon his heart would become quiet, and he would calm down and return home. Whenever the period of the coming of the revelation used to become long, he would do as before. But Gabriel would appear again before him and say to him what he had said before. Once more, Gabriel brings Allah's revelation. That the pause of Allah's revelation for a few days was to relieve the messenger of Allah and of the fear he experienced and to make him long for the revelation. When the shades of puzzle receded, the flowers of truth were raised, the messenger of Allah knew for sure that he had become the messenger of the great Lord. He was also certain that what had come to him was no more than the ambassador of inspiration. His waiting and longing for the coming of the revelation constituted a good reason for his steadfastness and self-possession. On the arrival of Allah's inspiration, Al-Bukhari reported on the authority of Jabir that he had heard the messenger of Allah speak about the period of pause as follows. While I was walking, I heard a voice from the sky. I looked up, and surely enough, it was the same angel who had visited me in the cave of Hira. He was sitting on a chair between the earth and the sky. I was very afraid of him and knelt on the ground. I went home to say, "Cover me up, cover me up. Allah, cover me, cover me. Allah, reveal to me the verses of you, Muhammad, enveloped in garments. Arise and warn, and your Lord Allah magnify, and your garments purify, and keep away from Al-Rujj, the idols." After that, the revelation started coming strongly, frequently, and regularly. Some details pertinent to the successive stages of revelation. Before we go into the details of the period of communicating the message of the prophethood, we will would like to get acquainted with the stages of the revelation which constituted the main source of the message and the subject matter of the call. Mentioning the stages of the revelation, the first, the period of true vision, it was the starting point of the revelation to the messenger of Allah. The second, what the angel invisibility cast in the prophet's mind and heart, the messenger of Allah, said, the noble spirit revealed to me, no soul will perish until it exhausts its due course. So fear Allah and gently request him. Never get so impatient to the verge of disobedience of Allah. What Allah has can never be acquired but through obedience to him. The third, the angel used to visit the messenger of Allah in the form of a human being and would speak to him directly. This would enable him to fully understand what the angel said. The angel was sometimes seen in this form by the prophet's companions. Before, the angel came to him like the toll of a bell, and this was the most difficult form because the angel used to seize him tightly and sweat would stream from his forehead even in the coldest day. If the prophet was on his camel, the camel would not withstand the weight, so it would immediately kneel down on the ground. Once the messenger of Allah had such a revelation, when he was sitting on his thigh, was a Zayd Zayd and felt the pressure had almost injured his thigh. The fifth, the prophet saw the angel in his actual form. The angel would reveal to him what Allah had ordered him to reveal. This, as mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Al-Najm, the star happened twice. The sixth, what Allah himself revealed to him in heaven, when he ascended to a heaven and received Allah's behest of Salat prayer. The seventh, Allah's words to his messenger at first. Had without the mediation of an angel. It was a privilege granted to Moses and clearly attested in the Quran, as it is attested to our Prophet. In the Surah Al-Isra, the night journey, some religious scholars added a controversial late stage in which they state that Allah spoke to the Prophet directly without a curtain in between. This issue remains, however, unconfirmed.